Hello, boys and girls. It's Mr. Barry with Pre-K 4 Literacy Lessons today. We're going to be learning still about zoo animals. We've got two that we're going to talk about today. The first of them is black and white stripes. What animal do you think that would be if we're going to talk about? I heard you say it, zebra. That's right. We're going to have the zebra today. The zebras have stripes that are kind of like our fingerprints. Fingerprints are the ones that you have on your hand. Nobody else on the entire earth has fingerprints just like you. And if your fingerprints can help identify you, and that, you know, that these are only yours. Well, it's kind of the same way with zebras. The stripes that they have, every single zebra's stripes, are a little bit different, and it kind of helps, you know, when sites are studying them to be able to identify them. So when you see the stripes on the zebra, you can know that that zebra doesn't look exactly like any other. And sometimes people would ask, does the zebra have, is it white stripes on a black body, or is it black stripes on a white body? Well, experts say that they believe that it's black stripes on a white body. So you can make your own guess on that. But that's what experts say that they think about zebras. Now, zebras are also related to an animal that we talked about in farm animals last week. Think about just a minute about the animals that we talked about last week. We talked about the chickens. Do you think it's related to the chickens? Well, probably not. What about the pigs? Does it kind of look like a pig? I don't think so. What about a cow? Well, his body's kind of shaped that way, but I don't think so. What about a horse? If you look at the zebra and you think about the horses, they look kind of alike, don't they? They're actually related. The zebra has the body that's shaped like a horse, kind of the same shape head, the same kind of ears, and also a mane that's kind of along the back of its neck right here. So you can see if we change its color to all one, maybe like brown or black or even white, we think, oh, that's a horse. But we know when we look at it with all the stripes, we know that that's a zebra. So that is one animal we're mentioning today. The other animal is the giraffe. Very, very different from the zebra. But the thing, of course, that makes the giraffe unique is its long neck, isn't it? So, and also, just like the zebra, the pattern of spots on the giraffe is kind of like the stripes on a zebra. They're very different between animals. So you're not going to find another giraffe that looks exactly like this one with the spots in the same place. So that's kind of one thing that's very neat about the giraffes as well. The giraffes are really very shy and quiet animals, not like the lions or the tigers that are not shy at all. But the giraffes kind of are. And also, one of the neat things about the giraffe has a tongue that is made to where it can get leaves and kind of around thorns. And if you ever see the picture of a giraffe eat, its tongue will just kind of go in all different directions. Well, a giraffe's tongue is actually 16 inches long. Look right here. Oh, my goodness. This is how long a giraffe's tongue would be. Oh my goodness. What would it be like if you had a tongue this long? When you opened your mouth and your tongue fell out like this? What would you do? That would be really silly, wouldn't it? Yes, I guess we're kind of lucky that God made us with a tongue that like this. And then also, the God gave the giraffe a tongue like this, where he can get the food that he needs from up in the trees. Now, the animals that we've talked about today, the giraffe and the zebra, are two more zoo animals that you can find at the zoo. Now, with zoo animals, when we have zoos, one of the reasons we have zoos is for animals that are endangered, and you know maybe they've been injured or something where they can't live in the wild anymore. And sometimes zoos are places where some of those animals can have a safe place to live. And then when they're living there, we're lucky that we can go see them and see up close what they look like. So if you have a chance, when we're able to get out again, to go to the zoo, and hope, I bet you'll be able to see some zebras and giraffes there. They're really wonderful animals. Now tomorrow, boys and girls, we're going to be talking about, I believe, kangaroos and koalas. So we will see you tomorrow, boys and girls. Have a good day. Bye-bye.